Как я уже говорила, процесс отбора был достаточно длительным, многоэтапным. Для многих пришлось неоднократно переделывать те презентации, которые вы собирались представлять. И в конечном итоге 11 команд, представленных на данном слайде, наконец вышли в финальный этап отбора. И я вам должна сказать и поздравить вас особенно, потому что именно секция «Персонифицированная медицина» была наиболее жестоко по конкуренции. Наибольшее число проектов подавались именно в эту секцию, поэтому поздравляю вас с вашим успехом. И я позволю пригласить на эту сцену Татьяну Никольскую, которая представляет первый проект «Росгендиагностика». И напомню, Татьяна, что у вас 4 минутки и 3 минуты на вопросы. Я вам передаю кликер и микрофон. Прошу вас. Дальше.
How does it work exactly? I would love to start, but I don't think.
Хотела бы уже начать, но что-то не работает, мне кажется.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for the opportunity to present my second startup at your conference.
Большое спасибо за эту возможность представить мой проект на этой конференции. Сегодня я представляю стартап-компанию российской диагностики, Росгендиагностика, которая разрабатывает продукты и услуги для различных фармацевтических компаний, докторов и пациентов в высокоточных технологиях борьбы с раком. Я работаю в этой области уже около 20 лет. Конечно, презентация буквально в течение 4 минут. Это достаточно сложная задача все рассказать, но я постараюсь. Каждый рак уникален, и поэтому, конечно, и подходы к ним должны быть уникальными. И мы стараемся найти такое правильное сочетание препаратов для каждого пациента, чтобы такой подход подошел именно ему. Мы достигли очень хороших результатов и работаем также с живыми.
Model is selling B2B products to doctors, oncologists, and also B2B and B2C services to pharmaceutical customers and
consumer.
Our products will have three components. NGS based primers, micro-panel, and decision-making software for oncologists. Our market is huge, both in Russia and globally. $90 billion will be spent this year on cancer drugs. Sadly, the average drug works only in 25% of cases, which is why cancer molecular diagnostic is so much needed and already launched in the US and some countries of Europe. Competition. In Russia, there are no serious competitors, at least not just yet. In the US, there are three companies worth mentioning, Foundation Medicine, Personal Genome Diagnostics, and Intervention Insights. Ironically, I know all the founders, we're good friends, collaborators, we have grants and papers together. They all subscribe to my former products, and I know their technology very well, but due to the sake of the time, I will move to our next topic, commercialization plan. In our case, commercialization plan is quite straightforward. We will start providing services to pharmaceutical customers who are former customers of Jingo, moving into the new area of us personalized medicine. Our pipeline is looking very good. Jingo products were sold to more than 10,000 users worldwide, so we have no doubts that we will succeed there. Followed by that, we will launch our first B2B project in 2014, next one in 2015, and finally in 2016, we plan to go to consumer market, launching B2C services. Our team is strong, successful, and complementary to each other. I bring to the table my experience in systems biology, existing pipeline of customers, and commercial success of Jingo, which I started in 2000 without any VC money nor angel, and sold in 2010 to Thomson Reuters. Sergey Tulandin brings his vast research clinical expertise and his impeccable reputation of one of the best oncologists in Russia. Alexander Hvad brings expertise in medicinal chemistry, and Michael Fedyanin, his innovative clinical research studies. Our needs are listed here. We're not exactly a newborn, we're about 2 years old, and we have successfully secured $1.5 million already. We're looking today for additional $1 million so we can launch our first product at the end of the next year. Thank you very much, and I'll take your questions. Yes, please. Am I supposed to share?
Извините, на вопросы. Сейчас одну секундочку передадим.
So, what is the reality? What is the basic of your projects? Please say me. This diagnostics or it's a treatment? This or theragnostics? Please say me in three words, maybe. What is the product? Yeah.
I'm not familiar with term theranostics, but perhaps not. Exactly. It's a very good term, and now I know it. Yes, exactly. It's in the same area. So we will do a diagnostic panel and a decision-making software that will be based on these things that will be encoded in a microarray platform as well as NGS panel of primers. So using this technology, doctors will know which drugs to use for patients. And
it's some kind of personalized medicine.
It is personalized medicine.
So you are looking for some antigen. I'm asking the reality. What is the reality?
We're looking for the best combination of existing drugs for individual tumors based on the molecular profile
Absolutely.
Of tumor.
Absolutely, thank you very much. What kind of drug you think for in your panel? What kind of, it's antibodies, or it will be low molecular drugs, inhibitor of tyrosine kinase receptors? I'm looking for this answer, yeah?
Sure, all kinds of drugs. All existing cancer
related not possible. Drugs. It's not possible, everything is not possible. It's
if
not
you
treatable.
Come from systems biology perspective,
yes, absolutely.
And you go by the target, everything that has been developed, whether it's kinase or a receptor or a standard chemotherapy, is applicable. Our goal is to find out which one and in what order and in what combinations might be effective for particular tumor.
What kind of cancer you are looking for?
It's for now, we're focusing on solid tumors.
Solid tumors. Thank you.
So I also have a couple of questions because I probably I wasn't enough attentive. So if I ask something what you told, I'm sorry for that. First of all, how are you going to identify? So that would be more like on DNA level. So you wouldn't do.
It's both RNA and DNA level.
Okay, RNA.
That is the advantage of the technology. Most people look on just one level, and a lot of them look just on actionable mutations. We bring to the table knowledge about activated pathways and decision-making algorithms because they there are rules that we developed that allow us to identify the actual combination. What brings more weight to the activation of the pathway mutation or the fact that pathway is already active?
Okay, I mean, that was the first question. The second, how do you, like, where do you see basically your market geographically? Because as far as I'm concerned, with all my respect, I mean, to my country, but I mean, there can be problems, even if you think, okay, that would be, let's say, the best combination of the drugs, just because due to that many of the drugs either not available or cannot be bought through the governmental system, which basically provide help for this expensive drug. So how do you basically see your market then? So would it be still Russian or?
Thank you for the excellent question. That is why we're different from our competitors. Most people work only on actionable mutations and they focused on targeted therapy. These are all my collaborators in US. This business model is not obviously going to work for Russia because first of all, we don't have experimental drugs in Russia. And second of all, the cost is prohibitive, really.
Приношу извинения, у нас ограничено тремя минутами на вопрос. Если вы хотите последнюю фразу какую-то сказать, важную, говорите, и мы будем переходить дальше.
So our goal is to launch the first product that will be oriented for standard chemotherapy lines, specifically for Russia, okay?
Okay.
Evaluated and move on into experimental drugs and move on into different markets as well.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Спасибо большое, Татьяна. Я приглашаю на... Можно презентер? Я приглашаю следующий проект. Мы перейдем, мы немножечко перескочим на онкометрикс, если вы не возражаете. На, да, потому что у нас изменилась утром презентация, поэтому давайте я приглашу сюда нашу четвертую команду, FTEC Bio, если вы не против. А мы пока заменим Иван. А мы пока поменяем предшествующую презентацию, окей? Спасибо большое. Пока Иван выходит, я попрошу жюри не забыть поставить оценки. И жюри попрошу также не забыть подписать свои листы. Прошу вас, Иван.
Добрый день, меня слышно? Здравствуйте, я Иван Афанасов, директор компании FTEC Bio. Мы резиденты Сколково, и наш проект – это экспресс-онкотест для домашнего применения. Все мы понимаем, как важно сегодня узнать о судьбоносных изменениях в своей жизни максимально рано. Например, женщина узнает о том, что она беременна с помощью простого и понятного метода, это тест-полоска. И представляете, сколько можно было бы избежать проблем, если было бы решение для такого же простого определения онкологических заболеваний на самой ранней стадии. Но, к сожалению, сегодня такого решения нет. Сегодня женщины в России не привыкли ходить к маммологу, и, к сожалению, более 90% случаев онкологических заболеваний выявляются на поздней стадии, а, соответственно, уже трудноизлечимы или вообще неизлечимы. Соответственно, рынку нужен простой, эффективный способ ранней диагностики, причем диагностики в домашних условиях. Мы хотим разработать такое решение и предлагаем свою тест-систему. Что это такое? Это тест-полоска, который состоит из полимерного носителя и иммобилизованных антител. Наше ноу-хау. Носитель мы делаем в виде нановолокон, а именно нанолент. Тем самым мы можем максимально увеличить функциональную поверхность носителя и расположить там максимальное количество антител. С другой стороны, полимерная основа – это хитозан. Хитозан содержит аминогруппу. И поэтому мы можем эквивалентно связать антитела с носителем. Что это даст? Это сохранит активность. Оба эти метода позволят нам добиться высокой чувствительности, что не было возможно для предыдущих поколений носителей. Другая сильная сторона нашего продукта – это простая визуализация, всего лишь при контакте с биологическим материалом. Мы выходим на растущий рынок, объем которого в 2020 году составит 6,4 миллиарда долларов. Сегодня, конечно, активно разрабатываются тест-системы для ранней диагностики, но все они относятся в основном к лабораторным методикам. То есть нужно прийти в больницу и, более того, нужно сдать кровь. А это не всегда психологически комфортно. В чем наши ключевые отличия от имеющихся сегодня решений? Мы не инвазивны, мы предлагаем простое и понятное решение, которое можно применять в домашних условиях. Как мы собираемся зарабатывать? Это продажи по двум каналам. Первая – продажа в аптеке через национальных дистрибьюторов. Вторая – продажи в больнице через партнера проекта, компании BioTechPharm, которая уже 12 лет работает на рынке медицинских изделий. Здесь я отмечу, что наше решение может быть с успехом интегрировано в существующую систему.
Directly, we can be integrated into the existing system of diagnostics as well. Our team, Vladislav Shemchugov, is the leader of the team, an expert in immunocorrective approaches. He is in charge of biotech results in the first medical university. We have also commercialized a couple of our products, Hitozan and Hitopran special tapes. We have a very good plan of research. We want $170,000 to prove the scientific principle of our product and to create a prototype. Second stage of the research, 25 million rubles for bringing the product into the market, starting sales in 2015. this device can be also used for identifying other diseases, not only cancer. So let's work together. Let's fight cancer together. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Any questions now, please? Any questions, please? Sorry, but what are you going to measure? Antibodies or antigens? What are you going to measure? Because I believe that the early diagnosis of cancer is not very specific, and doing that kind of work in clinics or polyclinics would be an exaggeration. Yes, today, quite a few startups are doing exactly what we are doing. Of course, we cannot concentrate many antibodies on that particular little site, but including antibodies that will get into contact with markers. No microphone. You know what? This is a problem that we can address within the framework of our project.
It depends. It depends. Up to you.
Up to me. Okay. So the main question is, according to your presentation, a person, woman may say, I have cancer or not. Yes? This is the main aim of your product. Yeah. So I'm absolutely in the same frame with the first person who asked you, because the cross-reactivity in your test will be enormous, I'm sure. You're a biochemist, immunologist, medical doctor. What's your basis?
Chemist.
Chemist, you know.
PhD in chemistry.
So I will say you may have a difference on KD, dissociation constant, maybe less than 10, one order. And it will bring you enormous cross-reactivity. So your test may fail. It will be psychological tragedy for the person.
Thanks for the question. Yeah, we're really concerned this problem, and that's a matter of future development for sure. But what I can say, it's much better to prevent than not to know what's going on. So this is just the idea that may help with the woman then to go to the doctor. We do not think that it's going to be 100% probability. It just will make the woman to go
Sorry,
to the
understand,
doctor.
Sorry, I understand. But the main thing is to do something realistic. So I would like to see the dissociation constants and real, measuring of your test. Without this data, we can't say that this project is good or not, because it will be really dramatic situation. The same situation was in case in 80s when people proposed different HIV tests. The false reactivity of this test was enormous, and it was a big problem for medicine of 18th century. So if you in case of HIV, you have the exact antigen against what you want to develop the test. In this case, in cancer, there are not big reality of these antigens. You can't say that. What antigen you put on your platform? Please say me. What kind structure? May you say it's HER2 neo or what you put?
We use specific monoclonic antibodies, and this stays inside of our know-how. But may I answer one question? This is a matter of our concern, of course, and if I could answer all the questions, I would possibly do, but this is why we are here and we're proposing this project. If we knew all the answers, the product would be already launched.
Скажите, пожалуйста, а вот стадия проекта сейчас какая? Вы говорите 170,000 на...
Now, about the stage of your project. You were talking about 86%. We've developed a carrier that has a maximum developed platform that can put in contact a fairly large number of antibodies. In other words, you have a platform that has some capability. Maybe you should not start from breast cancer, but from something much simpler. This is a hot topic to discuss. Yes, the methodology could be scaled for other options. Sorry, your 3 minutes are up. Thanks very much for talking out of turn. And now I would like to invite Aimslide Company to take the floor. You have 4 minutes. Good morning, colleagues. My name is Andrei Sinutin. I'm director of this company. We developed a new method to diagnose leukemia that can save hundreds of thousands of lives. Annually, about 250,000 of people die from leukemia, and leukemia is one of the major reasons for infantile mortality. Current diagnosis methodologies can identify the presence of that disease only in a very negligible number of cases. Only 4%. In other words, 96% of people with the leukemia condition do not know that they have that condition. We developed a new device which is very highly accurate compared to what we have, to the measurement instruments that we have today, and we can use it for mass screenings of leukemia. This is our technology. Pathological cells appear in the blood of a stricken person, including proteins and other substances. Studies on those cells are very important to diagnose leukemia, the leukemia condition. But at this moment in time, the methodologies that are used can only study and identify only the appearances of those bodies. And the equipment that is used there is highly expensive. At this moment in time, we have a ready-made prototype that that we use to diagnose over 100 patients, and they are and that methodology is patented. We also have consumables for that. Our clients are public and private sector laboratories, and we would like to take our product to the private market in the first place because it's much easier and quicker for us, and private players show a great deal of appetite for our project. ImmunoSlide is a breakthrough technology. It has no direct competitors. Existing competitors include major players, producers in the marketplaces, like Beckman Coulter and Beckman Dickinson. They also try to address this problem, but if you judge from this presentation here, you will see that we're one step ahead of them. The current or existing technologies are not good enough to achieve what we achieved. Together with Sergei Zukin, we came up with innovational technologies. Sofia Kuznetseva heads one of the laboratories in one of the leading Russian centers for blood cancer. She's also been awarded with a very highly prestigious prize. We also have Mr. Talukanov from Pennsylvania, and he founded one of the companies there, sponsored by Rosnano. We are also helped by Igor Pivovarov, who raised over 60 million project funds. The overall project is 40 million in Russia. Revenues in 5 years' time from now is 1.2 billion rubles. We need 50 million rubles to develop and produce a prototype for our product. These are our major success stories that demonstrate how successful we are as a team. Please, questions.
Sergei,
How do you differ? How are you different from immunocytochemistry? Three colors or what? There was one slide, an additional slide there, showing what we do. Our technology is transparent plate, transparent plate, clear plate. We put blood on that plate, and we start sorting them out. Depending on what sort of antigen is present there, and the dead blood is painted just like in the according to the morphology that we have for blood testing, and on just one glass for one patient. When you have, but say, when you have many patients there, yes, one glass for one patient. But of course, you can scale this technology. You can enlarge those glasses there, and you can use one glass for, or enlarge glass for many patients at the same time. That's more effective. And what antibodies do you have there that you put at the glass? We put different CD antibodies on our glass. At this moment in time, we work with a large number of antibodies, 36 all in all, including B cells, CD20, CD45. CD16 and so. In other words, you have those spots on your plates, right? Yes. What is the cross reactivity ratio for that? Because when you show those on the flow cytometer, then this issue is addressed, and the diagnosis you come up with is 100% accurate. And this is a wide spread practice across the world. That's why I'm asking this question. Do you believe that this methodology will be allowed to be used in the Russian Federation, or you will continue to use your technology only in your own kitchen, in a manner of speaking? Because flow cytometry is a 100% accurate technology. We compared our results for 100 patients, and there is a clear correlation of those results that we've achieved, 97% accurate. Did you do blended testing or tests and so on? Or did you collect regular medical statistics for the use of unknown patients? No. That was before the clinical stage. That was our sort of domestic testing. Thanks very much. And the next speaker now is Mikhail from Oncometrics company. Good morning. The Oncometrics company has been developed as a breakthrough technology for prostate cancer, to identify prostate cancer. Prostate cancer is number one now in men. And against this background, over half of the males over 50 years old demonstrate symptoms that can be caused by, say, age or infections, including cancer. In other words, all these people come to us for diagnosis, and this is not yet a fully perfect diagnosis, and we check the presence of on the bodies in the blood of that particular man. The statistics show that 70% of males do not need that kind of diagnosis because a simple specific antigen demonstrates very simple results. According to American statistics, it's over 1 million males a year. We identified new non-protein, blood markers from the prostate fiber. In other words, they are secreted. On this basis, we put together two tests to diagnose for diagnosis purposes at medical establishments, and then as an indicator of the prostate condition at home. The advantage of our methodology and markers is that we can measure a few markers by one tool in one test. This could be a very portable and affordable tool, non-invasive, easy to use, with quick results obtained. There is a potential market, huge potential market for that kind of test. There are over a million males that suffer from this condition there, and the overall amount of that market is about $4 billion annually. 350 million men globally have prostatic symptoms. Even if the 20% coverage of the market will give you huge profits. We've confirmed the results of our methodology on a large, by testing a large number of males. We have a patent issued for 45 markers. The specificity thing here, compared to specific antigens, we have the positive predictive value at the level of 15%, which is well above the average. Our team includes research workers and professionals in chemistry and biochemistry, and they've developed highly technological startups and so on. Now we are looking for an investor for the first stage, that is to improve our statistics. Thanks very much. We have our helpers here and our colleague Victoria. She will show how much time is left for you to continue. That's 1 minute and 30 seconds. One quick question now. What about your IP there in Russia and elsewhere in the world? Our parent company is based in England. We will arrive at BCB, and then we'll get another patent. Yes, 45 substances, and but their concentration rates are decreasing. We patented all the concentrations that we could find or identify. Michael, nice to meet you 5 years later. Your major innovation compared to a prosthetic antigen. You give a set, you produce a set of antigens, right? And then you combine them, right? And then you have to optimize the combination. The prosthetic antigen is a simple thing. If a patient has a drink or two in the evening, the test is bad. The test is no good. This is a world problem and a worldwide problem, and I'm happy to see you addressing this issue. Now, how many antigens will give you a good answer to your question? we know that a prosthetic antigen is not the gold standard now and against which to compare the results, but still. Yes, we have four markers, and each of them exceeds the specific antigen levels, and very close to 100%. That's from the human genome. No, these are low molecular combinations. They're not peptides, they're natural metabolites. That's a very interesting thing, unusual. In the absence of any further questions, one more question coming.
Very quick quantity. You claim 99% sensitivity, which is a wonderful figure, but you got it with 60 patients. It's impossible.
Well, so statistics for 60 patients plus 35 healthy controls.
Right, 35 healthy controls cannot give you 98% specificity, and 60 patients cannot give you 99% sensitivity. It's just not possible.
Well, no, so we operate with those numbers which we have, you know. So.
Thank you very much, Mikhail. Next presentation. I'm going to invite Lyudmila Teslab from Teslab. Your 4 minutes is on. Please, jury, put your marks to each presentation. Good morning. My name is Lyudmila. I'm director of Teslab company. I'm presenting development of methodology for screening of socially significant diseases on the composition of human saliva. So I'm not the first one to speak, and the urgency of oncology diseases has already been touched upon. But in the structure of morbidity, oncology is also sits together with heart and cardiovascular diseases. And in some stages, we can correct the lifestyle of people for the disease not to progress further. We present a methodology of for identifying ischemic heart disease and diabetes and some other diseases. Oncoscreening is also the thing we do, but we are just starting this, working in this area. Saliva as a diagnostics material. Our methodology is not invasive. Number two, features of the material also makes the diagnostics more efficient, and it is very easy to transport without any conservation means being used. We also offer the methodology that do not call for retrofitting of the labs and new equipment, and it is also applicable to people who cannot give their blood to test kids or elderly people. We have 7 patents and 2 know-hows. What is it about? A comprehensive test of saliva and its biochemical composition. Element number two, microcrystallizing of the biologic liquid and identifying the parameters of a crystallogram and processing this data, we get the results for testing. 94%, that's the sensitivity, that's the precision for identifying diabetes using this methodology. $300 million, that's the scope of the market in Russia. 5 to 7%, that's the growth rate of the market. 2 and 3% growth, 4 to 5 years, that's the level of development. We focus on laboratories and medical centers, and also insurance company can be our partners and clients, and also individuals who care about their health. Potential competitors, large network laboratories that do same research, same tests, but actually saliva tests. Our labs do not do that very often. Speaking about Mrs. Model,
in general, there are two models: a laboratory or a network of special premises for testing. We have a laboratory for all biochemical research. $130,000. That's the scope of investments we had, and we need more money for clinical research. A very ambitious team, chemists on the team, medical people, IT people, and machine building people are also on the team. $250,000, that's what we need. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much, Ludmila. Let's ask questions. How much time do you need for diagnostics characteristics? How quick can you do that? 4 to 5 hours. 94% precision. Did you publish these results in somewhere, or you just had the results as they are? It was research carried out. You said about crystallizing saliva. How can your results be communicated with and transferred to identifying cardiovascular diseases? Biochemical, if we speak about ischemic heart disease, we look at a special parameter. But the type of crystallization, how it correlates with the whole thing, it is about chemical combination of saliva. We cannot look at biochemistry analysis and crystallization. It's a comprehensive analysis. We look at it both at it simultaneously. I crystallized a lot in my life. How do you do that? Why do you need crystallization? I don't get it. Because the main component of saliva, various antibodies, there are lots of antibodies there, and other elements. And just individual protein can be crystallized. And the main difficulty about crystallization is that if your element is not clean enough, then it can't be crystallized. So maybe it's a great invention indeed, but if you speak about crystallization in the first place, I don't think it's a quick process, or I just don't get something about your methodology. Crystallization is carried out in normal conditions. We just put saliva to a glass, and when we just dry it, we have crystal structures as a result. It's not a crystal with its own grid. No, it's not a crystal. But there is no term for this kind of structures. And why do you dry why do you dry saliva? Because specific structures occur, and by these structures we can identify these or that disease. And looking at them, we understand what happens. So you can't get individual crystals during the process, but yes, we should invent a term, special term for it, but we do not have it yet. And for diabetes, what's the combination of elements that should be in place that you can say that it's diabetes? Standard approach to identifying this. It's a complex of parameter. Of course, we'll look at glucose, but it's not a specific thing. Another parameter are needed. Thank you very much, Ludmila. Next team, BioLink. You're welcome. You have 4 minutes for your presentation. And your clicker.
Ladies and gentlemen, my presentation is about lung cancer. This is the leading cause of cancer deaths today. And unfortunately, no effective chemotherapy is known up to now. For chemotherapy, it was real breakthrough in 2004 when it was shown that tyrosine kinase inhibitor show fantastic results in lung cancer treatment, but only if EGFR epidermal growth factor receptor mutations occur in tumor cells. So at least 10% of people can get one extra year of survival upon treatment of these inhibitors. But these people can be figured out only if tumor samples is analyzed. In this project, we are trying to analyze blood for all patients. If to consider that 70% of patients are of third and fourth stage of cancer, so it's not available, this tumor sample. If to analyze blood, this analysis will be available for all people. Why do we think it's possible to analyze it in blood? Together with our collaborative team, it was a new enzyme which allows to analyze its DNA polymerase with ability to analyze minute amount of degraded DNA. So we showed it's an experiment, and we strongly believe that it's possible to analyze a minute amount of DNA badly degraded, which goes from cancer cells. We got now the US patent application recently, just 1 month ago. The team which is working on the projects include several people who are quite experienced in the project. One guy was working in the laboratory of Nobel Prize winner for 5 years. One person was working in molecular biology laboratory in FDA in the United States. There are several young people. And we have experience in this particular project only working with tumors. It was funded by AstraZeneca, and we were selected as a laboratory who runs the regional project for tumors to support the use of their drug. Our company was the first who released to the Russian market the kit of reagents for analysis of this mutation for medical diagnostic, and it was registered in Russia. Regarding market, the growth of cancer molecular diagnostic market is approximately 30%, probably the fastest in molecular diagnostics. Global market, we estimate, is 100 million per year, and realistic to get something between 5% and 10% of share for the total market. Regarding sales, we have already sales of kits for the analysis inside tumor of this mutation, so we know the potential customers in Russia. Regarding sales over the world, we organize a special company, Biron Diagnostic, which is now selling the diagnostic kits, DNA diagnostic kits. It's sitting in Germany. It's actually a spin-off of our company. And we hope that it will help in international distribution. What do we need and why we are here? It's to turn the project into reality. We have just several experiments with diagnostic in blood of this circulating DNA and to get Skolkovo mini grant and to make the proof of concept, which we need approximately $300,000. So thank you very much, and welcome to Siberia. Somewhere here is our team is working in the forest.
Спасибо огромное. Вы были супер пунктуальны. Я прошу.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your presentation. Questions, please. You're welcome. Could you please tell us if I got it right? Your laboratory developed a test for non-cell types of cancer. Yes, that's what I meant. And now you have quite serious results in place. We have a special kit for analyzing tumors, but such materials are accessible to 70% of patients, and for this 70% of people, they can live a longer life if they go through these tests and mutations are identified.
Do you really need a specific polymerase to make your kit working?
Yes, that's for sure, because actually we have to do with very short fragments and with a extremely diluted DNA which is circulated in blood. It depends on the stage of the disease and depends on the particular patients. Every patient is different. And we know that with normal polymerase we can cover something like 20%, it's actually published from circulated DNA. To make it up, you need the polymerase which is working fine with a very small amount of material. And if you have interest, I can describe you. It actually quite enormous work to create such a polymerase with our collaborators. It's very special.
What is the source of this enzyme?
It's not source. It's genetically engineered.
But originally. It was,
it's actually a merger of two polymerases. It's a TAC polymerase and a bacillus polymerase, which is several bacillus polymerase. You can refer to 2V29 polymerase or bacillus tetrahydrofilamentous polymerases.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Next, our next project. Thank you very much for your presentation. Microspace company. Andrei, please, you're welcome. You have 4 minutes. Good morning, colleagues. My name is Blahin Andrei. My name is Blahin Andrei, director of and founder of Microspace, automated system for immunohistochemical analysis, IHC. It's a standard for histological diagnostics in analyzing malign tumors. Stage of the disease and better strategy for curing it. That's what normal analysis does, but there are some drawbacks about that about this approach. Everything is done through a microscope, and there is no special equipment for that, and no software. And sometimes during interpretation, some mistakes are done. That's why errors in the interpretation of the results of IHC occur, and no equipment is available. We've developed PathCore technology, which enables us to define the structure in the histological preparation, and also improve the accuracy of the results of IHC and flatten the results of the study of the objective assessment, classify the cell structures, and release the doctors from the calculations and computations. We have two elements about our technology, hardware and software parts. Three things about the first one, path detector, path machine and scanner, and path I and path DP. That's about software, and you can see the product on this slide. And how the system works, it identifies the cell structure and makes histochemical chemical analysis. Our market is B2G, B2B. We have a strategic partner in the B2G, BioVitrum it is called. Our main markets, systems with high level of visualization, histologically 10% of the market. That's the market of $14 billion a year, and it can grow up to $22 billion. And digital pathology, $191 million. That's the scope of the market, and it grows very rapidly. It is expected that it'll be $336 million in 2017, and lots of laboratories can also be our clients as well. Our direct competitors, no, we do not have them, only indirect competitors, software and equipment from Daco, Apera, and Definiens. From this chart, you can see that the precision of our analysis is about 99%, and our equipment can be used in any antibodies and all microscopes. And the equipment costs are quite low. We have two patents for the model. Our team, Andrei Blahin, that's me. I worked with projects in Rostelecom and also developed software for Sberbank. Frolov Sergei, mathematician, worked in Siemens.
professor, PhD, Zikov Evgeny, lead developer. He develops software. He developed GPS navigators some time ago. We have two offices in Tambov and Moscow. In Tambov, we do hardware R&D. In Moscow, software R&D. 24 people on the team. 7 of them are people from medicine. So we have a private investor. Thank you very much for your attention. God bless you. Thank you very much, colleagues. Your questions, please. You're welcome. You showed on a slide the price for your product. Why is it so? That's the full set of equipment with the automated machine and all other things. And this part, not the machine, but wet lab science, that's what they call it. Who does that? You mean histological preparations? Yes, Ventana company, that's the company that does that. They only assess their own products. If they have the process, then they think they think that diagnostics is accurate, but we can be installed in any laboratory. We are the final stage, you know, an instrument for a histologist. Could you please tell us regarding the forecast and of development and curing the patient? Forecast for curing. How you do that? Case by case from previous experience, or you have a direct methodology. Could you please cite a methodology that enables you to make the forecast real? Our approach is based on spectrophotometrics, and we found out the correlation between the length of the wave. But I can't give you more details about that. Andrei, just to clarify, for more clear diagnostics, because pathologists should do the whole analysis.
Now, what our system does is that it relieves the doctor from making calculations and estimates. But basically, does it cover all types of tumors? Yes. In histological terms, yeah, and then it is for the doctor to make a decision, right? Correct. So first comes the doctor, makes a decision, then your system identifies, and then the doctor makes a conclusion. Is that correct? I mean, the sick ones. Yes, that happens sometimes. This is the case in Russia. The doctor cuts out the tumor, and then sends the tissue to the lab for analysis and so on. In Russia now, is the calculations is the major problem. Most of our pathologists in post-Soviet countries do not have the requisite skills to make the earlier diagnosis of cancer, for example, lung cancer, and then to identify adenocarcinoma, and so on and so forth, or any other types of cancer. Your system can help only at the next stage, where we would like to clarify the previous diagnosis made to reduce the error margin. Yes, but that we have histological series or histological studies, but to obtain results from those, yes, in terms of whether it's good or bad, that's it. Now, I suggest you continue your discussion outside the forum here, and I would like to invite the next team. That's Biotech Innovations LLC. You have 4 minutes only. Distinguished jury, don't forget to make your assessments and sign your marks. My name is Ivan Akapkin. I'm director of Biotech. We're offering a product that will get about $3 billion at the marketplace. We're ahead of other competitors in this particular in fluorescent dyes. We've been in this marketplace for a number of years now, and we sell our products to 25 countries of the world. And our business model can be scaled 100%. Just a few technological data. Medical diagnostics and analysis call for fluorescent dyes to be used to illustrate the signals. Fluorescent dyes are good, but not that good in one respect. If you analyze a sample where you need to identify over 10 biological molecules, then you need to have a multi-stage analysis, which is not very comfortable. A solution to that is mass spectrometrics. And this is the product that we would like to come up with. The analysis of metabolites test screening and so on. The most popular methods of sequencing is mass tags, where you use fluorescent dyes. When you use commercial sequencing, you can reduce your costs about by 50%. That's $500 million across the world for potential clients that can use our product. The market of imaging reagents is now $300 million. By 2012, it's going to be $4 billion. And like sequencing methodologies will be produced for universities, labs, pharmaceutical companies, and so on. These clients will have appetite to use mass tags instead of fluorescent dyes, and this market is very encouraging. We have a number of competitors, but of which we are one step ahead. What we suggest offer here is thermal and scientific technologies. And the credit for that should go to our team that include businessmen and research workers. And I would like to introduce some of them. Alexey Yustinov is the project leader. He took our product to world markets. Ivan Akapkin, and I have a track record of making contracts with brand name companies on research and scientific issues. Vladimir Korshin is a world level scientist on nucleic acids. And Alexey Smolentsev has developed our product line and our business line, and he has a track record of about 12 years. We have a number of patents issued to us. We're now submitting a patent in Germany to be approved, and we are awaiting a decision on our grant request that we submitted to Skolkovo. Thanks very much for your attention, colleagues. Questions, please. If you identify on the basis of spectrometrics, why would you need fluorescent dyes? And in which part of the spectrum do you identify those? I didn't quite get your question. Spectrography replaces mass tags. Fluorescent markers will be changed or replaced by our product. You said that mass sequencing is based on Lee gas reactions. The only tool that we have today that is being dying very quietly is exactly this the tool that you're referring to now. I don't quite get what you said. Maybe you have some other examples to illustrate Liga's reactions. Now we're talking about insurance, rather, which is the very much in vogue. How are you going to be looking at mass tags? Are you going to use the mass spectrometer after sequencing? Yes, we will connect cheap mass spectrometers to our sequencing instruments. But we don't believe that what you said about Lagasse is a dead end. No, it is not. A cheap mass spectrometer will not be able to allow to have a large number of markers. Well, I don't think you can identify more than 10 molecules with the 9 trapper. We can identify a few hundred molecules easy, and now we have mass spectrometers that look like more sophisticated and more expensive tools, but they can cost up to $50,000, which is not that much. L7S, the L7S 2. You responded to my question in part. Is my understanding correct? When we heard the number you quoted, $50,000 for the equipment that will replace sequencing machines. No, there will be additional. But why would you need to pay that extra money? How will that affect your business model? How are you going to fight protons and others? The sequencing machine is rather expensive, and a device like this will not affect the original cost that or price that much. Thanks very much. We're moving to our new project, to our next project. That's iBinom. You have 4 minutes. I'm Andrei Afanasyev. I'm Director General of iBinom Company, of the iBinom Company. That's the cloud interpretation of genetic data, understandable for doctors. The interpretation of genetic data is one of the challenges that we face now. And the number of sequenced data continues to grow. We still use the measurement or measuring equipment that that was developed back in 1990s. This kind of applications are not quite software applications, that is, are not quite understandable or easy to use, to be used by doctors and biologists. Sequencing technologies and methodologies will not only help you identify various conditions that people have, but also sensitivity levels with respect to people who take drugs, medical drugs. A typical solution to the interpretation of genetic data is a software and a desktop. An analysis of one man's genome takes up to 24 hours. Our solution is the cloud service. In other words, the data enters our cloud, and we spend about half an hour to analyze a man's genome, starting from raw data to the final report. We do have competitors that software Celsibir. It's a very comfortable to use software, but a little slow. We also have a number of cloud competitors at the level of PT, and they are much slower than we are. And the analysis they do will cost you $1,000. We do the same job for half an hour and for $150. And none of those softwares can produce reports that will be legible and understandable for doctors. Now, take a look at the market here. In 2 years from now, the market will grow to $800 million. The number of sequenced binomes is growing very fast. And we believe we can do the job here. I manage a number of projects at RustNano. And I also worked for the Biotech Eurasia. One of our colleagues, Ignat Kolesnichenko, he's a programmer, and he developed the algorithm called Yandex. In addition to that, we have Valery Ilyinsky, who has a track record of work in various foreign labs. Now we need investment in the amount of $350,000 to develop a multifunctional version. At this moment in time, we have a version that proves the advantages that our model has. And now questions, please. Now, I believe that this is very encouraging. Now, there is a great deal of, there is a big market for animal genomes rather than human genomes. Do you think you can plan working in that area? And I think you will have some very tough competitors, but I wish you every luck. Yes, we can use any reference there. We can provide annotations for any case. What did you do to reduce the time needed that drastically? How did you do that? You need to have raw data to enter, and we reduced the time by using the MapReduce concept. In other words, we send our assignments to a cluster of machines using all sorts of providers, Amazon, VideoCenter, and others. And we also have an exclusive contract signed with and executed with Yandex.ru. And the second option is that we optimized the algorithms that we use. We avoided a lot of delays there, and that's why our procedures are that effective. And quality? Yes, quality parameters are quite comparable. When you're going to compete with products like Galaxy in Germany, we will compete in very simple terms. Our interface will be much better, and our report will be understandable for doctors. They do not produce reports understandable for doctors. For example, the mother-child analysis thing, and they what they have there is what informatics need. I didn't quite get your connection with the doctors, and you were rather vague in describing that. How do you know what doctors actually need? I've never met a doctor that will get some raw data and will get a solution that they need. Yeah. I know that there are doctors like that that act as researchers, and they operate in foreign countries. A doctor like that, I think you met a week ago at one of our international conferences here. That's Denis Rapokov. For that's what they do. They when they get a sick child with some genetic condition, and they don't understand why that condition appeared, and is Denis a doctor? He's a biologist, yes, but he acts as a doctor. But of course, a doctor will make a diagnosis. Thanks very much. I'll give the floor to Prima Life, Sergei Musienko.
My name is Sergei Musienko. I'm going to briefly describe you the project that I'm running called Primer Life. And very briefly, this is a platform for the interpretation of the raw genetic data and also the two-centric platform for consultations with the genetic counselors, licensed professionals in the US. So basically what we're doing is we're taking a close look at the human organism on the deeper into the cellular and into the molecular level at the double-strand DNA molecule. And most of you know that there is a bunch of companies in the US that are providing the S&P genotyping services today. This is the DTC consumer product. And the cost for the services is constantly falling down. So basically the test allows you to tell something about the disease risks and the carrier status for inherited conditions, as well as the drug response, ancestry and personal traits of the concrete person. So still the big question remains, both for the DTC and the sequencing companies, is now that you have your genome done, what you should do next? And based on the statistics from the US, almost 78% of the people who have done the genetic test would likely to go through the consultation with a healthcare professional. And basically, this is exactly what we decided to focus on. And what we're doing is we are providing an access to the licensed healthcare professionals focused on interpreting the genetic data and providing some kind of an action plan for the people who have done the test. And they are called the genetic counselors in the US. There are several boards of them in the US, and we are communicating with some of them. And the good thing about it is that the consultation can be held online or by phone, so you don't need to actually go to the office to them. And we're backing up the system with our own interpretation platform, which allows us not to be limited to the number of markers that these S&P genotyping companies are providing. And we're also adding another layer of the medical data and the family history data and some of the environmental factors that come from the questionnaires that people have to fill in on the website. So we have actually launched a very early beta already. So you can go on and register whether you have your genetic data or not. You can upload it if you have it. Well, actually this is an optional solution. And for all of the registered users, we provide an access to the list of the licensed genetic counselors on the website, which you can talk to and start discussions or sign up for the consultation with them. So basically, we have somewhat a different model for the monetization of the product, and which is based on the commissions that we are planning to charge from the counseling sessions with the GCs. And also the number of premium services for the people who have uploaded the data. So the core team comes from the Singularity University, which is based at NASA Ames Research Center in California. And this is where we have gathered the team, which have the biotech and AI and big data experience. And this is where we started the project. So our team believes that the genome, genetic and in general, the biological data one day, and we hope this day will come soon, will become the main platform for building a strategy of a human life, and this is our vision. So hopefully you will join us, and we can work together. Thank you. Any questions?
Please, your questions. Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome.
An interesting service, Sergey, because you're meeting a need which was created artificially. That is to say, the genetic testing availability provides information which most consumers of this information really cannot evaluate, and which frankly gives very few strong indicators. Right. For most people, they will only be alarmed that they are at a fivefold increased risk for something they had only a one in a million risk for to begin with. So now you're going to put them in touch with genetic counselors who will tell them you don't really need to worry. Is that right?
Well, in on the large scale, yes. But so the big goal is actually not to limit the people with the, you know, any action plans based solely on the genetic data. And for that, we're also planning to work with the, you know, with the medical data and family history. And yes, so the entire goal is to help people understand which is important and which is not. Thank you, Robert.
If I may, it was not very clear to me what kind of value do you add on the top of what Navigenics, 23andMe already adding. I mean, I probably missed it.
Yeah, right. So so we have two things. So the first one is we're allowing you to add the medical data for the consideration of the healthcare professionals. I mean, your own medical data and then the medical data of your family members. And the second thing is
where do you obtain the data?
Well, right now it's informed. It has the form of the questionnaires, but we're planning to work with the EHR in future. But right now it's basically the questionnaires and huge questionnaires. And the second thing is actually the consultation itself. So we're providing the counseling sessions.
How are you going to scale up?
Well, so right now we can see the niche market which we're targeting. This is the specifically the genetic counseling sessions. So this is the first thing. Next thing, we definitely plan to go towards the physicians and try to meet their needs. But right now,
what I meant, entering the data takes time. How many people do you need to have to get the data, enter in the system, and help someone to interpret something?
How many? You mean the experts, right?
People who enter clinical data into the system.
Right. Well, I mean, for us, it's entirely optional. So the more data you provide, the better results you can get. I'm sorry, I probably
not
didn't...
Not answering my question, yeah, but I'll carry on later on.
All right. Thank you. Thanks.
Спасибо большое, Сергей.
Thank you very much, Sergey. And we start our final project in this session. Start the presentation. Innovative diagnostic systems. You have 4 minutes for your presentation and the clicker. Good morning, colleagues. Let me introduce a microarray system for molecular genetic analysis for identifying allergies. Allergies across Russia and abroad grow with each year, and allergic diseases start from an early age. Stage by stage development of allergy and very wide scale distribution of such diseases, and it is very important that we identify the allergy at early stages. We will have a DNA chip, a silicon platform in a framework with oligonucleotide meters on it. And main consumers of our product will be kids with dermatitis in their early ages of their life. We sell service, so we sell analysis that we will do in our lab. And we also offer better diagnostics at the early stages of disease. Clinics, diagnostic centers, research institutes, those are our customers. We sell a business model. We offer better wider product range for the company, and company manufacturers, chip manufacturers. can also be our clients. We sell licenses. We have competitors and competitive advantages. We have Biochip, IMB in Russia, in USA and Europe, Affymetrix, Agilent Technologies, BioRad Laboratories, but we have also advantages. We offer silicon platform, and it is very solid, solid material, and also some other advantages that are typical to this material. We have a Russian patent for this silicon platform. We have a know-how for primers sequence, and international patent. We applied for international patent for early diagnostics of allergies. Why are we going to sell the products very well? Because we are better and faster than others. It is quicker than what is used today in the market, because we have more markers and it is more of high quality, because you can use and it is very reliable, because you can use the silicon platform, silicon plate many times. Plant sales, second year, 25,000 units, 70,000 during the third year, so 64 million rubles. That's the forecasted amount of sales. We have an agreement, a contract with mandatory insurance fund, and this project will be a pilot project for the Tomsk region in Russia. The team implementing the project, project manager, molecular biologist, engineer technologist, and laboratory assistant researcher, Svetlana Savilova, project manager, project management professional, molecular biologist, it's me. I am experienced in Yura Prevail and Gabriel, engineer Petrova Irina, participated in development. Thank you very much. Your questions, please. You're welcome. I can see there are lots of them. Hello, two questions. How did you resolve this fundamental issue that it is very difficult to identify diseases through biochips? Because what we have today in terms of chips, they do not identify diseases properly. And number two, why should people know about the allergies? They just know that they have one, and they do not eat something that triggers the allergy. So, in terms of, from the point of view of consumers, do they need this analysis at all? Of course, they do, because we've carried out research, large research, more than 5,000 people in the Siberian region, and basing on the results, we've got molecular targets for such pathology. Atopic march, that's the concept. We have to prevent the disease to develop further, and we carried out research and molecular docking, and we know how. We didn't just look at risks and understand what associates with what, but we looked at targets and how they trigger allergies. Excuse me, I don't get the whole thing about the essence of the project. You do oligonucleotide sequences. What are they? They correspond with molecular targets. So you do prediction basing on the genome, yes. But it's a polygenome thing. Of course, it's a polygene disease. I think lots of false signals are coming if you use this methodology. But your clients, why do they need this? If they know about their allergies, they can try everything, but afterwards they can limit themselves and stop eating something and change their lifestyle. We are not speaking about eating habits, but we know the mechanism now, and development of a new preparation is on, understanding the molecular mechanisms. You do have a patent for that, and what's a preparation? What is that? It is not. We didn't get a patent yet. You're speaking about silicon. All chips on glass are patented. Well, what differentiates you from other companies and similar products? They have good equipment for avoiding false signals and all, so parameters are quite good. About our silicon plate, we've patented a technology for this silicon plate, nanostructured silicon, but it is not very cheap. It is more expensive. Yes, of course, but comparing to Affymetrix, for instance, thank you. Thank you very much. Can I get the clicker? Esteemed colleagues, thank you very much for your attention. We've completed this session. I'd like to say thank you to our esteemed jury for their active participation in this session. And could you please fill in your forms and sign the forms. Thank you very much to all the presenters. Tomorrow at 9:30, we will announce the finalists. Please come and join us. I wish you good luck, and I hope you will find yourself among finalists. Next session on immunotherapy and disease and infection fighting will start at 1:30.